The amount, A, of the radioactive isotope carbon-14 that is left in an organism T years after it has died is modeled by the equation A equals A sub 0 times E to the negative 0.000124 T, where A sub 0 is the initial amount of carbon-14 in the organism at the time of death. Suppose an excavation near Edinburgh, Scotland, unearths a human skeleton, and that testing reveals that the level of carbon-14 in the bones has decayed to 95.22% of its original amount. How many years ago did this person die? Well, the way this works is that we're all carbon-based life forms, and carbon has an atomic mass or atomic number of 12, and we also have a small, very small amount of a radioactive isotope, carbon-14, very slightly radioactive. And it's about constant during our time of being alive, and a concentration in the bones of this carbon-14. And then when an organism dies, this carbon-14 begins to decay at a constant rate. So just like other radioactive isotopes do, this one decays pretty slowly. Others decay faster or sometimes slower for different isotopes of different elements. In any event, this carbon dating technique is really pretty good for dating things that are hundreds of years old or even into the thousands of years old, but not into the millions, and there's another isotope. Okay, so what we have is, it says, how many years ago did this die? First of all, that means that we are solving for T. T is the number of years. Okay, this A, let's talk about the A. A is equal to 95.22% of the original A. So we'll write that down right now. A equals 0.9522 times the original amount. So instead of writing A in the equation again, we're going to write 0.9522 times A sub 0. So let's write that. I'll use a bright color so you can see it. That's 0.9522 A sub 0 equals A sub 0, writing the rest of the equation, A sub 0 times E to the negative 0.000124 times T. Now we can divide each side by the A sub 0, and those would cancel out. And now we'll write what's left, and that's 0.9522 equals E to the negative 0.000124T. Now the process for solving for an exponent is to isolate the base and its exponent, and we've done that here. We have just the base and its exponent, and now we can take the logarithm of each side. I prefer to take the natural log, so we'll do that, natural log of this, of each side, and because of the properties of logarithms, we can say that this exponent, if you take the logarithm of something raised to an exponent, you can take that exponent and move it out front. So we'll do that. So rewriting then, we have the natural log of 0.9522, I'll put that in to parentheses, equals negative 0.000124 times T times the natural log of E. Now, the reason it's nice to use natural logarithms, especially when your base is E, is that the natural log of E is just 1. You could memorize that or just plug it into your calculator to get that. Now we have this linear equation. You could certainly evaluate this on your calculator and get some decimal answer, and that would be okay. I'm going to leave it intact there, and then you could type it in all at once into your calculator. So let's divide each side by the coefficient. So negative 0.000124 is what we're dividing by. Negative. Make sure you do that negative. Otherwise, you'll get a funny answer. Okay, now, when you type this all into your calculator at once, make sure that you take the natural log and then end the parentheses before you divide by this negative 0.000124. If you don't end the parentheses, you'll just get the wrong answer. So follow those steps, and here's a good test because you can follow along and do it here. So now we have t left, so I'm just going to write t first, and I'm going to switch to a nice color for our conclusion. And I have t equals 395 years ago. So this person died 395 years ago. And it just so happens that a person that lived in Edinburgh, Scotland, 395 years ago was John Napier. And John Napier is most famous. Well, now he is. At the time, he was famous for other things, but now he's most famous for being the person who discovered logarithms. So this was just a little play on that. But there's also something else, a little math humor for you, if you will, that there is something called Napier's Bones. And Napier's Bones is actually a calculating device. It's a rigid, tactile device used for multiplying and dividing big numbers. But in any event, what we've done is we found the exponent 395 years.